Dear colleagues, let me introduce myself. My name is Alena Favorskaya. My course is Vasily Golubev. We work at Moscow Institute of Physics and Technology. And today I'm going to discuss with you elastic and acoustic approximations for solving direct problems of human head ultrasonic study. The presentation is organized as follows. Firstly, some words about relevance and scientific novelty when we will discuss boundary value problem of elastic wave phenomena, and then we'll discuss accurate formula for pressure in elastic medium two-dimensional case because it has some meaning for comparison elastic and acoustic waves in a human head. Then some words about boundary value problem describing acoustic wave phenomena, when we will see calculated using grid characteristic methods wave patterns, and then we will discuss the obtained conclusions about comparison and about all investigation totally. These two slides are about relevance and scientific novelty, and the main idea is that mostly in order to obtain ultrasonic image of human head, the acoustic approximation is used because it can save computational resources, but most of waves in a human head occurring when ultrasound study is neglected, and it might be some features in human body that can be recognized only using novel methods for ultrasound based on elastic waves. A lot of projects of this kind are in seismic prospecting, and the direct and inverse problems of ultrasonic study is similar, but now the frequencies are used and so on. Let's discuss boundary value problem describing elastic wave phenomena in human head. Here we can see human head and two axes along OX1 and along OX2 directions. And here there are some layers in the human head. Some of them are very, very thin, and they can see here at this picture. And all layers are colored as shown here, and the table of speeds of waves and density are here. These elastic and acoustic parameters are here. And at this slide, we can see our boundary value problem. This is acoustic wave equation. Also, we solve elastic wave equation to describe cerebrospinal fluid in a human head, and between acoustic and elastic wave equation we use this contact condition, and also we use this boundary condition, and here is our ultrasound source, and here there is a condition between two elastic layers with different elastic characteristics as shown in this table. And also zero initial conditions have been used in this boundary value problem. Accurate formula for pressure in two-dimensional case might be written as follows, because most of people think that if in 3D case is this formula, then in 2D case will be only sigma 1,1 plus sigma 2,2 divided by 2. But the accurate formula is like this, because sigma 3,3 is not zero and depends on sum of sigmas 1,1 and 2,2. And in the case of boundary conditions, the total pressure in acoustic case is with this coefficient. So we compare velocity model wave patterns to be accurate. Boundary value problem of acoustic wave equation is at this slide. Here there is the same acoustic wave equation and similar boundary condition, and these conditions are used between different acoustic layers, and also zero initial conditions have been used. Notice that these contact conditions was used between different meshes of cerebrospinal fluid in a previous elastic case, but it is a numerical feature, and mathematically our coupled elastic and acoustic wave equations boundary value problem looks like as at this slide. So let's move on to wave patterns pictures with different frequencies at a different time moment. You can see that then wave is propagated from the source to the center of a human head. There is no significant difference between acoustic and elastic wave phenomena. And also for another frequency, there is the same result, but for another frequency, there are a lot of waves in skull and skin and fat layers, and they are absent in the case of acoustic wave phenomena. In conclusion, so we will understood this reason. And also we can understood this reason if we investigate the propagation at another time moments in elastic and acoustic case. Here we can see a lot of reflected waves, including shear waves. And in the case of larger frequency, they reflect, and so there is a decay in these types of waves, so we obtain no waves in human skull and skin and fat. But in the case of less frequency, there is no such kind of a reflection, and we obtain these waves. Also, at another time moment, in another scale of coordinates, also we can see the decay of these waves in the case of a larger frequency. And the similar time moments of acoustic waves. And the significant difference here we can see at less frequencies as well. So some conclusions, some of them are also compensated. There are two slides with conclusions, and the main idea have been said, and also it is should be noted that it is known from physical experiments that at frequencies of megahertz, shear waves decay in tissues, and in our numerical experiments, the same results have been obtained. And the main conclusion is that based on the performed wave phenomena analysis, in the future it is possible to develop methods of ultrasound diagnostics based on shear and converted waves for use in cases where classical methods of ultrasound studies cannot help. But in connection with features of the statement of the problem, using acoustic approximation to solve inverse problems of ultrasound data it can be used because there is no significant difference here. So thank you for your attention. That's all.